Hello, my name is Verena Wiener and I will present to you our work Breaking the Screen, Interaction Across Touchscreen Boundaries in Virtual Reality for Mobile Knowledge Workers. VR has the potential to transform mobile knowledge work because, for example, it provides a large display space and it is possible to display layers of information that can be perceived through depth. The spatial interaction used in VR works if the user is in a wide space, but not so good in places with limited space, which is common for mobile knowledge workers. The solution we evaluated is to use a touch device to interact with virtual content. This can also be combined with additional modalities like gaze tracking. So we evaluated how to arrange and manipulate information in a joint interaction space of HMDs and tablets. Related work in the area of mixed reality for knowledge work would be from Schneider et al., who used immersiveness of VR to change the input and output characteristics of a visual keyboard. In the area of spatial interaction, there's the work from Surale et al., who defined a set of design dimensions and guidelines by using a tablet in VR for 3D modeling. Pfeiffer et al. Used eye gaze and touch. So when the user's gaze is near the touch position, this results in a direct touch input, and when the gaze and touch are separate, the touch input is redirected to the gaze. So in our work, we want to examine how to support mobile knowledge workers through joint VR and tablet interactions. The assumptions we had was the already mentioned limited space, and that we want to use mostly 2D applications, like common office applications. We implemented a set of 6 VR applications that can support mobile knowledge workers, including, for example, a window manager and a map. You can find more information about them in our paper. In an iterative process, we explored different possible interaction designs. This led to the following design space that we evaluated in more detail. There are different possibilities for arranging multiple 2D information windows around the user. One possibility is to arrange the windows in depth. This means one window is on the physical device, and then there are also windows behind and in front of it. This can, for example, be seen in our map navigation and our PowerPoint application. Another possibility is to arrange the windows around the user. It is also possible to do both, spatial arrangement around the user and then also additional depth layers. This can, for example, be seen in our window manager and code version control applications. There are also multiple possibilities of interacting with these multiple screens. We evaluate 2 possible techniques for efficient switching of the screens. The first is a bimanual technique, where the user can switch the screens by touching the bezel of the touchscreen with the non-dominant hand, while swiping with the dominant hand to change the active window. Our second technique combines eye gaze and touch, so the active window is always the one the user is currently looking at, and touch is only used inside the screen. This can also be seen in our window manager application. In our user study, we compared the previously mentioned input techniques and 2 techniques for presenting layered information. So, first we will have a look at input space and then at the output space. We used the content transfer task to compare the gaze-based approach and the bimanual approach. The task was to grab an object with the cursor and place it on the indicated target position, which was displayed on another window. On the left side, you can see the gaze-based approach, where the active window is always the window that the user is looking at. And within this window, the cursor can be moved by using the touchscreen like a touchpad. On the right, you see the bimanual technique, where the user has to touch the tablet's bezel and then swipe through the windows. We use the 2x2 within subject design for this evaluation. The independent variables were interaction technique, which was either bimanual or gaze touch, and the number of screens, which was either 4 or 15. The dependent variables were task completion time, accuracy, task load, VR sickness and usability. We recruited 14 participants, which all had prior VR experience, and the setup consisted of a HTC Vive Pro Eye and a Huawei tablet. We attached Velcro at the borders of the tablet to support the participants in identifying the touchscreen boundaries. And then the tablet was placed in front of the user. First, participants filled out a demographic questionnaire. Then they performed the eye calibration. We had two tasks to investigate around screen interaction and depth interaction separately. We counterbalanced all tasks and conditions to avoid ordering effects. For all conditions, the participants had a training phase and then they did the real tasks. And after each condition, they filled out questionnaires. At the end of each task, a questionnaire about the preferences was done and we conducted a semi-structured interview. The main results of the content transfer task were that the participants acquired the target significantly faster with the gaze-based method compared to the bimanual. The gaze-based method resulted also in significantly higher usability ratings. All but one participant preferred the gaze-based technique because it was faster, more intuitive, and less fatiguing. There were no significant differences regarding accuracy or simulator sickness. The second task was a puzzle task. We used it to quantify the benefits of viewing stacked information in depth. The participants were presented with an image of multiple colored squares at the top. Below were multiple layers containing one square each placed somewhere on the layer. We asked the participants to place the colored squares as displayed on the top, so they had to navigate through the layers and correct the positions of the squares. The two techniques that we used were the depth technique, where the information layers were presented at different depths, and the flat condition, where all layers were at the same depth. For this evaluation, we also used the 2x2 within subjects design. The independent variables were the visualization, which was either flat or depth, and the number of layers, which was either 4 or 10. The dependent variables were the same as before. The main results from the puzzle task were that the participants were significantly faster with the depth visualization compared to the flat, about 14%. Also, the depth resulted in significantly lower mental demand and a higher usability score. All but one participant preferred the depth condition because they found that it provides more information and they could better see where the pieces are. In a second user study, we presented a range of 6 applications to get initial user reactions, which were quite good. We found that applications are easy to use, useful and enjoyable. So in conclusion, we explored different dimensions of the extended display space in VR by focusing on small tablets as input for mobile knowledge workers. We developed 6 knowledge worker applications, probing the design space and showed that they are usable and enjoyable. We found that the combination of gaze and touch is beneficial for interaction with virtual multi-window environments, and that the use of depth is about 14% more efficient compared to a 2D visualization. For future work, the application concepts should be studied in depth to better understand the capabilities and limitations. We also want to study the effects of physical and virtual screen sizes, and the effects of fully mobile implementations in the real-world environment. Also, we want to explore further multimodal interaction techniques that fit this shallow 3D space, like for example a pen. Thank you for listening, and by the way, there's also the code of mobile implementations available on GitLab.